suffering. And who are suffering? Those who could have paid the taxes. Who can now afford to set up a Honda generator as a backup? But he won't pay the electricity bill. He would rather spend money on the Honda generator, or whatever name you can call it, the small portable generator at home, coughing away and polluting the air and kerosene. But he won't pay the bill, because he has lost faith that he will get good quality power. Sometimes we've reached a stage where you need to do surgery. Medicines no longer exist. Some diseases have no other option, especially when gangrene sets in. Is amputation. I have never been a great one for privatization, let me tell you that very bluntly. Especially in the services sector where large investments are required. Whenever large investments are required, I do not think Indian industry has still matured to the level economically to jump in fully in large investment areas in infrastructure. So what happens? You are going to have invariably your rich brethren from across the seas coming in and investing their good money to make good money. And we are all going to finally help them. I have nothing against it, but it's a reality you must have your eyes open to. And therefore I don't rush for it. Somebody asked me, why did I do this NTPC, NHPC acquisition and merger? It was not to bail Yashwant Sinha out. That's a bonus he's got by accident. But the real truth is, I was consolidating two of my large corporations, just like ABB and Alstom did in France and Germany. If they can do it, why can't we do it? But then that's not acceptable, because what you must do is to privatize, which means sell your asset to somebody. If one of you could have bought it, I have no objection. But the only problem is every megawatt costs 4 crores. So even a small 100 megawatt power station is 400 crores. Not very many can buy it, in India at least. Even the two generating plants which were sold in Orissa were bought by an American company. To them, when they convert it into millions of dollars, it sounds small. But to us, we earn in rupees, and therefore looks large. What we have done is, we have made NTPC, which is a 41,000 crore asset company, and another 20,000 crore asset company of NHPC get together to show a balance sheet of 61,000 crores, with a debt of only 16,000 crores, with an equity of almost 12,500 crores. Now we've got so much of leverage that I can now pick up money or finance new projects, especially in the hydro sector, which is falling behind. We have a problem in this country. It is said to be technically that if you don't have 40% of your power, which is hydro, you cannot run a grid because you have peaking problems. It's a human habit. We are not machines. We switch on the AC the moment we feel hot. And all of us do it simultaneously. We don't consult each other. We don't load share. Suddenly on the circuit, a heavy load comes and the circuit fails. That's what's called peaking power. The moment that happens, hydro you can switch on in a minute. But any thermal power takes you at least 3 hours to come online. So we need hydro power. The ratio, which should be 40-60, has gone down to 25-75. We need minimum 20,000 megawatts of power in the next 5 years in hydro, which means an investment of approximately 60 to 80,000 crores. Where is this money going to come from? Government of India's budget can't give it. Private individuals cannot raise that sort of money. If it's all going to come from international investors, I think we are dreaming. So we have to use our strengths, leverage ourselves, become financially smart, learn the games, and pick up the money and build these power stations. The moment you do that, you're criticized. What is the biggest criticism that has been given to me in the last couple of weeks is that what do you mean by acquisition? So I said, what's wrong? If ABB can acquire Alstom and vice versa, what's wrong with NHPC and NTPC doing a marriage of convenience which is going to help both parties? NHPC has got the hydro technical know-how, NTPC has got the money. Let's mate the two and make more hydro projects and earn more money. This is good, normal business sense. Okay, in the process, NHPC wants to keep its identity. A merger would mean that I need not waste money. Give money to Yashwantji and his consolidated fund. But if NHPC's identity has to be kept, then you'll have to pay for the shares. So we paid for the shares. But nothing wrong. But if you look, put it like that, nobody accepts. They say, no. You are doing this only to help Yashwant Sinha. Are bhai, Yashwant Sinha has told me he'll give this money back. Because it's not part of his disinvestment plan. I don't need it immediately, but I need it the moment my hydro projects take off. Then I need lot more money, not 4,500. I've got to touch the 80,000 crore mark. So why I'm explaining this to you is that the power problems are large. Huge investments are coming. And I think industry needs to understand across the board that you need to conserve consumption of electricity, at the same time encourage honest payment of bills. Once industry does it, let me tell you, the rest will follow automatically. Because there cannot be a single house which consumes more than 10 kilowatts of power which does not have the backing of one industry or the other, other than being a politician, of course. I don't know, but that's really the truth, because 10 kilowatts is a lot of power to consume, and it is only this 10 plus kilowatt consumers who really start indulging in theft, whether domestic or industrial. Now if you take a conscious decision that in order to save the power sector you are willing to do this, I think you will be really bringing a revolution which will save my power sector. The other option is, of course, privatize everything, which means you might be placing yourself at the hands of a person who knows how to extract money from you more than you need to pay. Anyway, I wish you the best. I have given my viewpoint. I thank you for the option. I also want to tell you that we are coming up with a bill for conservation of energy. We'll be laying down norms as to what efficiency should be maintained, and if those manufacturers don't maintain that efficiency, they might be faced with certain penal consequences. But the reason why we're going a little anarchic here is to ensure that at least manufacturers manufacture equipment which are energy efficient and not energy drags. But what is happening is that a lot of our energy is also going waste because of inefficient designs of most of the motors, actuators and other equipment which convert electrical energy to kinetic energy. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Sir,
please.
I'm wondering what gets given and why in the street. And we are passing great prices because of the non-payment of the large amount of rent by state exports.
They have no money.
Three years, 4 years, they are taking, placing orders, accepting the order, taking the order from material from railways without payment and not giving us payment for 3 years, 4 years. What to do?
This is a problem. I am not denying this. When I said 30,000 crores, I was not joking. Yes, cable industry may be just 1,000 out of that 30,000. But for you, 1,000 crores is a huge amount. We are, the whole genesis of the problem is somewhere else. The problem is nobody thinks that power needs to be paid for. They think it's like sun or water or energy that is God gifted, not manufactured. See, unless Most of Indian industry, if you don't mind my saying, cable, even fuel, a lot of fuel industry is dependent on power. And unless we change the psyche, we will never be able to solve your problem. Yeah, I can give them a little more loan.
I would like to request you to hold your question. Then let the minister complete it.
No, I finished. I said thank you.
बिजली जो रेट का फर्क आ रहा है जिसके कारण करोड़ों रुपए का बिजली बोर्ड को नुकसान हो रहा है या एक इंडस्ट्री को दूसरी स्टेट के हिसाब से हो रहा है उसके अंदर आपका क्या कहना चाहते हैं। एक एग्जांपल है यूपी के अंदर फर्नेसिस को 1.09 रुपए में बिजली मिल रही है और राजस्थान में 3.95 रुपए, पंजाब के अंदर 2.95 रुपए और बिहार के अंदर 2.09 रुपए, जो इतना डिफरेंस है जहाँ पे ये इलेक्ट्रिकल इनका रॉ मटेरियल है उसके कारण जो लीगली फर्क आ रहा है उसके अंदर आप क्या कर रहे हैं इस बारे में आपका क्या विचार?
देखिए ये तो क्रॉस सब्सिडाइजेशन जो करते हैं विभिन्न तरीके से करते हैं। उत्तर प्रदेश में वो चाहते हैं कि फर्नेस इंडस्ट्रीज को ज्यादा महत्व दे रहे हैं तो इसलिए वो कम कर रहे हैं। 1 रुपया तो कॉस्ट से कम ही होगा सब्सिडाइज रेट, क्योंकि अंदाजन में एवरेज कॉस्ट ऑफ डिलीवरी ऑफ पावर हमारे देश में 2.40 रुपए है। जो भी रेट 2.40 रुपए से कम आज के दिन में है वो कहीं ना कहीं से क्रॉस सब्सिडाइज्ड है। ये एवरेज, हाँ थोड़ी बहुत इधर उधर 10% तुम कह सकते हो, 20 भी नहीं हो सकता है। लेकिन ये जो बात आप कह रहे हैं बात सही है, लेकिन ये सेल्स टैक्स जैसी बात है। आप चंडीगढ़ में जाके गाड़ी खरीद लें तो कम दाम में मिलता है क्योंकि वो सेल्स टैक्स नहीं डालते हैं। कई लोग दिल्ली से बड़े खुंदक में हैं आसपास के जो प्रदेश है, क्योंकि वो कहते हैं दिल्ली वाले सारे टैक्स को कम कर देते और सारा इंडस्ट्री बंद हो गई। ये तो है ही, ये एक जनरल प्रॉब्लम है जो इमीडिएटली सॉल्व नहीं हो सकता है। ये वंस दी जो स्टेट रेगुलेटरी इलेक्ट्रिसिटी कमीशन आ जाएंगे उसके बाद मैं समझता हूँ थोड़ी बहुत, पूरी तरह से नहीं होगा, थोड़ी बहुत सिमिलैरिटीज इन टैरिफ्स हो जाएगा। यूनिफॉर्म टैरिफ रेट कभी नहीं हो सकता है, कारण कॉस्ट ऑफ पावर डिफर्स इन डिफरेंट प्लेसेस। आप एक उदाहरण दे देता हूँ, नहीं इट इज नॉट ए नेशनल ग्रिड, मैं माफ कीजिए, मैं लेट मी क्लैरिफाई क्या हुआ कि वी डोंट हैव रेट इक्वलाइजेशन, जो एक जमाने में स्टील में होता था आपको याद होगा कि आप स्टील कहीं भी देश में खरीदो एक रेट में मिलता है क्योंकि फ्रेट इक्वलाइजेशन होता है। सिमिलरली पावर का एक ट्रांसमिशन जो व्हीलिंग चार्जेस है वो इक्वल नहीं है, क्योंकि सपोज तमिलनाडु buys power from Talcher, which we are planning to. It's a 2000 kilometer transmission line. There is some approximately 20 paise added on the cost.
The transmission is not there.
Now let us take Punjab. Punjab has got hydro project, the Bhakra Dangal. They get the power at 6 paise. So those four states will share Bhakra Dangal power. Can afford to give lower tariffs. Now you don't have Bhakra Dangal power available for others. It's a reality. It's consumed there itself locally as a load center. Now equalization of tariffs is something which is not possible unless you are able to reach a situation where all the power that belongs to the area is bought and paid by one authority. The danger of that is that you would lose actually the choice of getting cheaper power and competition will go down. See, आपको साफ साफ बता दूं, कहना है तो यह है कि BBMB एक है, पास में ही आप एक थर्मल प्रोजेक्ट ले लीजिए, कहीं है थर्मल प्रोजेक्ट का रेट अंदाजन 2 से 2.5 रुपया होता है, पुराने